In this video, we'll take a closer look at hydrates and molecular formulas. A hydrated salt is a salt that has crystallized from an aqueous solution. Chemicals that form hydrates can be used to absorb water vapor to keep air dry where it's important, such as around sensitive equipment. It may look dry, but when it's heated, it liberates very large quantities of water. During the heating process, the crystals change color and are converted into an anhydrous form, which just means they lack water in their crystal structure. To calculate a hydrate's empirical formula, first determine the moles of water that have been driven off. Then, find the moles of the anhydrous, or dry, salt that are left. Next, determine the lowest whole number mole ratio of the anhydrous salt to the water. Write the formula for the hydrate by writing the moles of anhydrous salt separated by the moles of water associated with it, separated by a dot. Here's a practice problem which asks you to calculate the empirical formula for a hydrate. A 15.67 gram sample of a magnesium carbonate hydrate was heated, driving off the water only. After heating was complete, the mass was 7.58 grams. What is the empirical formula of the hydrate? The first step is to figure out the mass of water that was driven off. To do that, take the mass of the hydrated salt, which was 15.67 grams, and subtract the mass of the anhydrous salt, what was left after heating. 8.09 grams of water were driven off during the heating process. Next, take that mass of water, 8.09 grams, and convert it to moles using the molar mass of water, which is 18.02 grams. After dividing the mass of water driven off by the molar mass of water, we have 0.449 moles of water that were driven off. Now, take the mass of the anhydrous magnesium carbonate, 7.58 grams, and convert that to moles using the molar mass of magnesium carbonate, which is 84.31 grams. So, 7.58 grams of magnesium carbonate divided by 84.31 is 0.0899 moles of magnesium carbonate. Now you are ready to figure out the empirical formula for this hydrated salt. Divide 0.0899 moles of magnesium carbonate into 0.449 moles of water. That will give you the ratio of the moles of water to moles of the anhydrous magnesium carbonate, and that ratio is 5 moles of water for every 1 mole of magnesium carbonate. This is how you write the formula for the hydrated compound. Again, this dot does not mean multiplied by. This is just the way you represent hydrated compounds. Empirical formulas represent the reduced subscript formula for a compound, but may not always represent the actual number of each element present in a molecule or formula unit of a substance. We use empirical formulas to calculate molecular formulas, which are true formulas that show the number of all the atoms that are present in a molecule. To calculate a molecular formula, first find the empirical formula if it's not already given. Then determine the empirical formula mass. You find this the same way that you calculate the molar mass for any other compound. Just add up the molar masses of all the elements that make up the empirical formula. The next step is to divide that molecular mass from the compound by the empirical formula mass. Then, multiply each subscript in the empirical formula by the number you found in the previous step, when you divided the molecular mass by the empirical formula mass. And here are a couple of equations to illustrate that process. This first box says to take the molar mass and divide it by the empirical formula mass to get some number, an integer, n, if you will. Then distribute that integer to all the subscripts in the empirical formula. Here's a problem in which we have to calculate the molecular formula. This problem tells us that the empirical formula for ethylene is CH2. We need to find the molecular formula if the molar mass of the compound is 28.1 grams per mole. The empirical formula mass is found from taking 12 from carbon plus the 2 from hydrogen, and we get 14.03 grams per mole as the empirical formula mass. The molecular mass, which was given in the problem, is 28.1. When you divide those two, we get 2.00. That becomes the subscript that we distribute to all of the subscripts from the empirical formula. The 2 distributes here to the 2 from hydrogen, so we multiply 2 times 2 to get the new subscript of 4 for hydrogen. And the 2 distributes here to the carbon, multiply 2 times the understood 1, and you get the new subscript of 2 for carbon. So the molecular formula for this compound is C2H4. Now here's one for you to try. The empirical formula of a compound is NO2. The molar mass of the compound is 92.0 grams per mole. What is the molecular formula? When you're ready, pause the video and work the problem. When you're ready, press play and see if you got it. Here's the answer. If you got N2O4 for the molecular formula for this compound, good work. The process was to take the molar mass that was given in the problem, 92.0, and divide that by 46, which was simply the mass of nitrogen dioxide, NO2. And you get an integer of 2. Take that 2 and distribute it to all the subscripts inside the empirical formula. So the 2 gets distributed to the nitrogen, that's how we got the N2, and then the 2 distributed to the 2 from oxygen ends up being 2 times 2, or 4, for oxygen. And N2O4 is the molecular formula for this compound. That's a closer look at hydrates and molecular formulas. For more chemistry matters, go to the homepage where the entire series is available to you.